Thank you very much, Belinda. Thank you very much to ClientEarth for organizing this panel and for the invitation. In my very short intervention, I will just give you a flavor, try to give you a flavor of this interesting, exciting, and I would dare to say eventful recent history of just transition in Greece and the role of NGOs in it. We can't talk about just transition without talking about Lignite first. Lignite has played a huge role in Greece's energy mix. For many years, Greece was number three in the EU behind Poland and Germany in lignite mining, despite its small size. But as you can see in this plot right here, around 2013, lignite production has started to drop dramatically, especially since 2017 and 2018, when CO2 prices have started to skyrocket. Lignite has been experiencing one after the other historic lows. Obviously, a very significant moment, milestone, I would say, was that the announcement by the Greek Prime Minister last year, 13 months ago in the UN, about the phase out decision by 2023, essentially, or 2028, if you want to count also the complete seizure of all lignite plants, which is a decision that made Greece the very first lignite producing country in the EU that will phase out lignite. Now, many factors contributed to this historic decision. NGOs and think tanks played a significant role in it, essentially through documentation-based advocacy work. The very first, I would say that 2013 was a milestone, because at this particular moment, we started focusing, shifting our attention from arguments related to air pollution and climate change to purely the economics of lignite plants. The very first report was published in 2013. You can see it right now. It's actually behind. It was on the bad economics of two new lignite plants that were being designed at the time. Many reports like that followed. And finally, in 2019, just a few weeks before the announcement of the phase out, we published this report, which shows the economic dead end, essentially, of the lignite industry in Greece under many different scenarios and many different parameters. Although for many years we've been vigorously advocating in favor of a lignite phase out for a variety of reasons, we were equally concerned about the situation, the future of lignite regions in Greece, essentially because we knew that many livelihoods were dependent on lignite related activities. So back in 2016, many years before the phase out decision, quite the opposite, I would say, we published the first quantitative roadmap for the transition of Western Macedonia to the post-lignite era. Western Macedonia is the main lignite region in Greece. With this report, we showed that if investments are made in 12 specific sustainable economic activities, then more jobs and more regional GDP can be generated compared to the ones that will be lost due to the retirement of lignite plants and the seizure, the overall seizure of lignite activities. We've also published a policy analysis very recently on the history of just transition in Greece and made policy recommendations for addressing current and future challenges. And around the same time, so July of this year, we published a quantitative analysis which attempts to suggest ways in which the EU Just Transition Fund that Alexandru explained and described can be made more fair and more just in terms of its allocation between the member states, of the fund among the member states. Now, a very big part of our work throughout the years, the last 5 years, I would say, was done in collaboration with mayors. Marta explained very well why mayors. It's because they know the problems very well. They are very close to the local communities, and they can also influence the central governments, at least in Greece. So the first effort that we made was back in 2015-2016 to try to get funding for the lignite regions through the allowances, the CO2 allowances that allocated to Greece. The first attempt failed. It was a long and arduous effort. But 2 years ago, we revived the ask together with the mayors, and we managed to persuade the government to channel 6% of the public revenue from ETS auctioning towards the lignite regions. This made Greece again the first member state in the EU to utilize the corresponding provision of the EU ETS directive. We also involved the mayors in EU policy work. We tried to involve them also in our advocacy efforts together with the European Trade Union Confederation to establish a distinct EU Just Transition Fund, but not as part of the multi-annual financial framework that Alexander described, but as part of the EU ETS reform back again in 2015. Now, we failed in this attempt. A distinct just transition fund was not established, but the silver lining was that another fund within the EU ETS, the modernization fund, could be used for just transition purposes for 10 member states. And that was really the first fresh money for just transition that were allocated by the EU. We also support the work of the advocacy efforts of mayors to make the Just Transition Fund more fair by taking into account the speed of transition and the magnitude of the challenge in EU's coal regions. We collaborate with them in their participation, coal regions in transition. And also, as Marta mentioned, we helped them set up the Forum of Just Transition Mayors and organize the first event in Kozani back in 2018. Where are we now? Well, Greece was the first EU member state which presented a national just transition plan, and they put it up for public consultation. According to this plan, there is going to be a lot of PV parks in lignite mining regions, 2.55 gigawatts, which is a huge capacity if you consider the size of Greece. There are also two investments in battery production, large scale and small scale, and also a green hydrogen production unit, as well as investments in a field of energy research and technology. So with these kind of ideas and investments that are well developed in the plan, are described in the plan, Greece's two lignite regions, Western Macedonia and Megalopolis, will be transformed essentially from centers of pollution to centers of renewable energy, energy storage, and hopefully innovation regarding these technologies. The plan also includes investments in other economic activities other than energy, smart agriculture, wine tourism, rehabilitation facility, also investments in the pharmaceutical industry, etc. But not everything is sunny and rosy. There are big challenges ahead. I would say that undoubtedly the biggest challenge is time. The existing lignite plants will be retired in 3 years, and we don't have a completed transition plan yet. Another big problem is participation. The design up to now has been essentially top-down, which is a big mistake, because we know that for a successful transition, we need the broadest possible participation from all categories of key stakeholders. And we need that in the planning stage, and we also need that in the implementation stage through a democratic governance mechanism. Governance mechanism does not exist right now, and it's, you know, postponed for the future. We also need political agreement between parties. We don't have that because right now the parties are still arguing the phase-out decision instead of discussing the situation and what's the future of lignite regions. Finally, obviously, there is funding. Without getting into too much detail, funding right now is neither enough nor secure and steady for the long term, which is an essential prerequisite for success in the transition process. Finally, Greece is becoming a pioneering country when it comes to transition issues. Good or bad, we don't know, we will see. But it's worth reflecting on the lessons that we learned in this short 5-year history that is associated with just transition in Greece. The very first lesson is that we lost valuable time. Governments and the public power corporation were trying for many years to prolong the life of lignite-based electricity instead of designing the future both at the national level and the regional level for the lignite regions. But once the decision was made and announced, things accelerated in the right direction significantly. So the lesson is that one needs to announce, take this decision and announce it as early as possible, so there's enough time to design and implement a just transition process for the lignite regions. The other lesson is that the role of mayors is pivotal. They have accomplished so much. They have acted as catalysts on many levels at the regional and national and even EU levels. They also initiated the public debate with the local communities, and they brought together different types of stakeholders, including NGOs and trade unions. Now, regarding this very last point, the results in the case of Western Macedonia, especially in Greece, show that this kind of collaboration with NGOs and trade unions is not only possible, but very useful and necessary. Now, thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you very much for this very great introduction, bearing in mind that